This is Gateway 3, a key component of Powerwall systems. These are the dimensions of the enclosure. The front door is opened by pressing in on the door and pushing in on this latch. When open, the door can be fully removed by lifting straight up, disengaging these two pins. Behind the door is the dead front cover. The dead front cover has knockouts for up to 8 Eaton, Siemens, or Square D breakers mounted on the internal panel board and for an optional main breaker. An opening in the dead front aligns with a reset button for the islanding contactor. The dead front is secured to the enclosure with this screw. Remove the dead front to access the internal components. These are the supply terminals, where the incoming power supply lands. The supply lugs can be removed and replaced with the main breaker when gateway is fed with service conductors. Gateway accepts either Eaton main breakers or Square D main breakers rated from 100 to 200 amps. Following the busing up from the supply terminals is the islanding contactor, which serves two functions: disconnecting the line and load side during an outage and measuring the overall current flowing in and out of the home. There is a reset button for the islanding contactor located here. Busing exits the islanding contactor and ends at these backup lugs labeled line 1 and line 2. These two lugs are capable of double lugging two wires, provided that they are the same size and conductor material. This internal panel board is pre-installed in Gateway and can be used to interconnect breakers for power wall, solar, wall connector, or backed up loads. A breaker hold down bracket is included with Gateway as a means of physically securing breakers to the panel. This factory installed jumper connects the internal panel board to the backup lugs. These two screws and the jumper can be removed when local code requires a disconnecting means before the power generating breakers. On either side of the backup lugs are the neutral terminals, 3 large lugs and 10 smaller lugs on this neutral bar. The ground terminals are located at the bottom right of the enclosure. This is the factory-installed neutral-to-ground bonding screw. This is left in place whenever gateway is the main service disconnect and must be removed when gateway is not being used as service equipment. On the side of the islanding contactor is a connector for communication with Powerwall. For more information about mounting, wiring, and commissioning Gateway 3, watch the other videos in this series.